What about a microwave? Well, we actually personally don't own a microwave, but if you were to own a microwave, there are a few things to consider. The microwave presents a problem in that its walls are usually made of plastic, and you can't kasher plastic, you can't put that under a libun, even a libun kal, to be able to take out any of the taste which may have been absorbed in the walls. But the microwave does present another point, and that is that it doesn't necessarily bring the walls to such a temperature which absorption can be created in the first place. In order to test this, the best thing to do would be to take a cup of water and to put that cup of water into the microwave or to cook any other substance in it for a good few minutes so that one can see the steam, one can see it's really hot. Immediately open up the microwave, open the door and put one's hand on the ceiling of the microwave. If one is able to keep one's hand there for more than a few seconds, or 10-15 seconds, then obviously the ceiling has not reached a temperature high enough in order to be able to have absorptions of chametz into it, and the microwave can simply be cleaned very thoroughly, left for 24 hours, and one would put one cup of water, fully boil it out, and then remove the actual plate and put another cup of water in at another angle and boil that out as well. That would be sufficient to kasher such a microwave. If the ceiling is hot enough that one would have to take one's hand back, then that microwave cannot be kashered because it has reached an absorption temperature sufficient to absorb chametz taste, but there's no way to extract that because of the nature of the material that it's made from. It's also recommended that the OU suggests that one needs to remove the actual plate, the actual glass revolving plate, and perhaps one can use something else, another substance, on a cardboard frame at the bottom just to be able to hold things up, or styrofoam. Some suggest even saran wrapping a few times the plate itself we used in the microwave. One cannot be cooking on it directly. And the OU also suggests putting a cover over the window of the microwave itself, obviously not covering the vents. If one's using a convection microwave oven, which is in a certain sense a combination of a microwave and really an oven itself, the convection microwave oven actually now sends the heat around as well. Well, in that case, it could actually reach the temperature of a libun kal and therefore should be treated like a conventional oven. The way to test if one can actually reach that temperature in the first place is what one would need to do is put it on its highest temperature for a good while and open the door immediately and put a piece of paper against the edge. If the piece of paper will start singeing, then that reaches a libun kal temperature and one would be able to kasher it by the way one could kasher a regular oven. That would be to clean it, wait 24 hours, put it on its highest temperature for 40 minutes and one would be so sufficiently done. If however the paper is not singed, then it doesn't reach a high enough temperature to get to a libun kal, and therefore we are in the same situation as a regular microwave which has now absorptions in the wall but there's no way of extraction. In that case, such a convection microwave oven would be taped closed and not used over the course of Pesach.